Next topic on the board, Ross Dellinger. Conference USA reaches out to AAC to consider reorganizing the leagues into two new conferences split on geographic lines. Have you seen this story?
Yeah, I saw it.
The Conference USA Commissioner, Judy McLeod, is leading a proposal that's kind of deemed a long shot here. Saturday Blitz suggested last week a reorganization, if you will, of the three G5 conferences that are located in, you know, the southeastern, like from Texas up to the Northeast, right? The MAC is already basically regional. The Mountain West is basically already regional. You don't need to worry about those. It's the AAC, or at least the remaining teams in the AAC, the Sun Belt, and Conference USA. From there, I mean, you get into this story, and basically 3 years ago would have been the time to do this. But now, the reason it is deemed a long shot is because of, basically, there are two classes of G5s, right? You've got the AAC, who was making like $7 million per school, and then you've got like Conference USA, who's making $500,000 a school. And there is a line between those two, right? It's almost as big as the line between, say, the SEC and a Pac-12 school. Now, everybody kind of looks at them the same, but they also understand, the Pac-12, they don't care as much about football as the SEC. Their fans don't care as much, and the programs don't care as much, and blah, 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 blah. It kind of, I don't know that this would work, but I do like the idea of it. What was your thought on it?
Nice. I think it's a nice try. I don't think it's going to work. And, you know, if I'm the American, I probably wouldn't do it.
I think it would depend on what the media deals would be. Like, I would at least talk to ESPN and whoever else, CBS Sports Network, about this and see what this would bring, right? I do wonder if, I mean, hell, you and I have brought up multiple times, just reorganizing everything into one giant, like G5 conference, and setting up pods so that you play your regional rivals, right? The way that this one is set up right now, let me read off what these conferences would be. The Western Conference would include SMU, North Texas, Rice, UTEP, Southern Miss, Tulane, Tulsa, Louisiana Tech, Wichita State in basketball, UAB, Memphis, and UTSA. Now, the Eastern Conference would feature East Carolina, Charlotte, Old Dominion, Temple, Marshall, FAU, FIU, South Florida, Middle Tennessee, Western Kentucky, and then two potential new additions, which Matt Brown has come out and said that UMass, like Massachusetts, is kind of pushing to be included in something along these lines. But outside of that, maybe Liberty would be included. You'd be looking at an independent, basically, to bring in somebody. The reason they're not including the Sun Belt in this is there is zero interest from Sun Belt leaders in doing anything like this. Now, Mike Oresko, the commissioner of the AAC, has come out and basically said, nah, this ain't happening. Like, he's not interested in this, but he has not officially said this to Conference USA. Judy McLeod said, as the conferences continue to realign, I think all of those issues are being considered as schools are trying to figure out where do they want to be, and conferences try to figure out which schools they want to have as members. But revenue is driving these decisions, and geography is not. So more money is being made, but more money is being spent in these solutions. She briefly described her reorganization proposals with other commissioners, but doesn't know if people are willing to get in. She said, I don't really understand the fear and paranoia about getting some groups together and talking. With all the uncertainty right now in college athletics, there's a chance for us to build something stable. And I think it is. I think it is something stable. Conference USA actually employs the former Big Ten commissioner, Jim Delaney, who, after he retired from the Big Ten, has got his hands in everything. He's a consultant with the Rose Bowl. He's a consultant with Conference USA. I mean, it's just a mess. But I do think that it's a good idea. I just don't think it's going to happen because of egos. And that is so frustrating to continue to see this sport being driven by people whose egos are just too big for their britches. Hey, you kind of feel the same way.
No, I don't think it's about ego at all. Like, you're asking the American to give up. The American has bigger teams to lose than Conference USA. And so if you're asking them to drop off some of marquee teams in marquee big cities, and they don't want to do that. And I understand not wanting to do that.
No, I understand that as well. That's why I said you go and have a conversation with ESPN about this. You go and figure out, hey, what is the best solution so that we don't have to spend as much money and yet we still get a bigger piece of the pie, right? Because they are about their income is about to drop down to half of what they're bringing in per school. Because without Cincinnati, Houston, and UCF.
But that's as they are at city now. I think if you're the American, you assume that at some point in time, you're going to find three other schools to join you, if not more. Or you're going to fall apart. One of those two things is going to happen. Either more schools are going to get picked off, or you're going to find a way to bring three more in.
And we've talked about schools that they should look at, right? If you are the AAC, you go talk to Marshall.
I would not want to lose Navy. I think Navy's important. If you can add Army, then you've done an unbelievable thing. That one game alone a year would make the conference nut.
You're not wrong about that. The problem there is that Army has kind of made it clear that they prefer their independence status, like their independent status.
That's fine, but even then, like I still, you're asking them to give up Navy, or to give up like the teams in the South, like Memphis. Like okay. I wouldn't want to do either of those.
Agreed. Now, I mean, you're trying to figure out a way to make it more, and I will say this, it does make a lot more sense when you include the Sun Belt. But if the Sun Belt ain't willing to play ball, then why in the world should the AAC, right? Like the AAC, obviously, a bigger, better conference.
What should happen is if the AAC, the American is still better than the other three. If the American can poach UAB, and, you know, Coastal Carolina and App State, then, you know, or maybe a Louisiana too. Like, then those other two, then the Sun Belt is so crippled that they have to merge with, you know, Conference USA, and that has to happen. And that's probably better because the American was a better conference, and they've got bigger cities with a lot more money. So while App State might be better than most of the teams in the American, UAB might be better than most of the teams in the American. Like, they don't have as much money. They don't have as much money as Memphis. They don't have as much money as South Florida. Like, they just don't have the resources. Yeah. So, the best schools from those conferences join the American, poach them, pull them away, keep the money you're making now, and you know, you might lose some, but you won't lose a ton. And then you can go forward, you know, and those other two conferences can try to merge and do whatever they're wanting to do.
Yeah, there's still so many different ways that this thing can go. It's so.
But I don't think that's ego driving it. I only have eight schools left if you're the American, or six schools left if you're the American, right?
Yeah.
But my six schools are better than your 12. So why would I merge with you? Why would I merge together?
Yeah, if I've only got eight and you've got 14, and my eight are still better than your 14, why would I split them up? Like,
why would I do this? This doesn't make sense. So it's not an ego thing. It's a, you got to make it make sense for me. So yes, it makes sense for you because your non-revenue sports can't afford to do this. Well, we aren't having a problem with our non-revenue sports right now. Okay. And we might one day, but I'm assuming at some point in time, they've got a plan to replace the three schools they lost.
Yeah.
And they've tried a couple of swings and they've missed all of them, but they were trying to go out west. Which I didn't hate the idea of, but I also didn't think that was the best thing because you know how I feel. I would go get Coastal. I would go get App. I would go get Louisiana. And I'd go get UAB. I'd make those four phone calls first because those are local. Those are regional.
Yeah, absolutely. If you can pry them away from the Sun Belt, yes. That's the biggest question, right? Who can you convince to come over to the AAC? Everybody has been talking about UAB. That is the next big prize piece because of the market in which they reside. And I would imagine they'll be able to pry UAB away from Conference USA. And once that happens...
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah, once that happens, then, I mean, do you go to 12 if you're the AAC? Because then you start trying to pull Sun Belt. Or do you just go to 10 and you've just got a 10-team league just like the Big 12, you know, what do you shoot for? And you try and figure out where the value is. So, I mean, props to CUSA for, like, giving it a shot, because I think that there is a lot of it that does make sense. You know, you and I both are on record with wanting a lot more of these regional rivalries and games that actually matter, right? But, like, specifically where we are in Memphis, you want, you know, UAB, Southern Miss, Arkansas State, like those kind of games where it's easier to get there and the game would actually mean something as opposed to it just being a crazy regular season game, right? You want it to actually mean something. But, I mean, as far as money goes, yeah, until it can make sense financially, you're right. There's no reason to do it. So, I mean, we'll see what CUSA proposes, what they actually send over. But, yeah, I don't foresee it happening. Don't foresee it happening. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.